Well, Bob, here's a big one for you. Our next guest turned bullish in late February when he said, cover your shorts, and predicted that the sharp rally would take hold, and that's exactly what we've seen. Perma-bear Robert Prechter is now bearish once again. Bob is the founder and CEO of Elliott Wave International. He joins me now to explain what's behind this bearish stance. Good to have you with us, sir. Thanks so much for joining us.
Oh, thanks for having me. I can remember the days when I was a perma bull.
You can, huh? So what was it? I want to ask you about, you know, turning bullish back when, and you were so right about that in a moment, but what is it right now that you see causing you to turn so bearish once again?
Well, I've been pretty quiet for the last 5 months, sort of sitting on the sidelines watching the rally. It's been a beautiful run, 350 S&P points in 5 months. That's a 50% jump. At this point, we're seeing the opposite of the kind of readings we saw at the low. At the low, we had only 3% of traders bullish. That was one of the lowest readings ever. In early August, we got two back-to-back days of 88% bulls. So that's one thing to look at. We've also got what might may be a completed Elliott wave pattern. Back in early March, our upside target was 1,000 to 1,100 on the S&P. You know, we got pretty well into the lower end of that range. That's enough for me. I don't think anybody who comes in this late is going to get 50% out of the market on the upside. We've also had declining volume throughout the rally. So a lot of things came together in the first week of August to get me to put out an issue a week and a half early and say that's enough for us.
Interesting. So in addition to the volume and certainly the valuation, which you note, what about the fundamental backdrop? You know, a lot of people questioned the rally as it was moving higher because the economic landscape hadn't changed all that much. What do you see in terms of the landscape, which, of course, supports the market?
Well, usually the economic numbers provide a very good cover for the market when it's ready to turn. I'm sure you remember in late February, early March, the big story was the biggest contraction since the Great Depression. Everybody's got to be afraid, and they were. And now that we've rallied for 5 months, the economists are pretty much unanimous in saying that the recession is over or nearly so. I think this is a depression, not a recession, with bear market rallies along the way. And each one of these rallies is going to lead to an improvement in the economy. We're finally seeing those results, the results of 5 months of increasing optimism showing up in the economy. To us, this is a very normal progression. But I think to other people that use those things to make their decisions in the stock market, they generally tend to lag.
You know, you also have a great prediction on the dollar, which I want to get to in a moment. But before I move over there, let me ask you about equities in terms of practical results here. So if we were to see the sell-off accentuate going forward into year-end, what do I want to do in terms of my own portfolio? How do I need to position myself here? Do I go 100% short? Do I want to keep cash on the sidelines, have some exposure to equities, international markets, or what? What's your sort of preferred allocated portfolio here?
Well, when I wrote Conquer the Crash, I said the average investor should be in the safest cash equivalents and stay there for the whole bear market. If you're a trader, we've offered some opportunities to be short and then cover. And what I told people after the close of the 5th of August was, look, if you really are a trader and you've got money that you can afford to risk, you can probably go about 50% back in the short side. Remember, we only came to the lower end of this upside target we had. That could well be enough. A 38% retracement is one of the percentages that we watch. If the market does decide to put a second leg on later this year, we'll probably use that to get even more aggressive. But most people, I would say, really shouldn't play in that kind of manner, because markets can be very devastating to people who take a speculative or a leveraged position. And I think many people are too cavalier in telling people to do that sort of thing. So safety is my main word.
All right. On to currencies. Mr. Prechter, one of your major predictions here is that the dollar is forming a major bottom and perhaps beginning a multi-year advance. Can you tell us a little about that?
Well, I brought a chart, and if we've got all the pieces on it, I'd like to talk about this for a minute.
I think we have your chart. Let's show Robert's chart here.
Go ahead, because to me, this is the single most interesting chart on the board. People don't pay enough attention to it. One of the things I mentioned in Conquer the Crash was, as we get into this deflationary period, you're going to see more and more markets trending together. We call it the all-the-same-markets phenomenon, and it's been happening more and more. Other people have called it no place to hide. But in any case, what you've got is every market pretty much moving together, real estate, stocks, commodities, all moving up and down roughly together. But they're contrary to this graph. This is the chart of the price of the US dollar index. It's against the euro and some other currencies as well. But look at how important this graph is. Take a look at that left-hand arrow we have over at the bottom left.
Right.
That's pointing to the March low in the dollar, and if you recall, I'm sure you do, that's when the precious metals made their high ticks. Gold was over 1,000, silver was $21. Then, when the dollar tested its low in July of 2008, that's when oil topped out at $147.50. Then we had this tremendous move up in the dollar, and this was a reflection of the credit crisis. This is when all the other markets were falling very hard, and the only one going up was the dollar, because as debt was being retired and contracting in value, the remaining dollars were gaining. Now take a look at that arrow at the high. That was almost to the day, a week after you and I were talking, when the stock market bottomed and the dollar topped, because that's when liquidity began to return along with optimism for these last 5 months. Well, here we were on the 5th of August. This is one of the reasons I published early. We had only 3% bulls on the dollar. It looked like we were topping out in the stock market. And if these markets continue to be contracyclical, as I think they will be, you're going to see a rising dollar for quite a period of time, along with falling markets in the other direction. And if you'll notice that 3% bulls that we had on the 5th of August, that was the same reading we had on March the 6th, March the 9th, and the stock market when it bottomed out.
So real quick then, Mr. Prechter, as the dollar rallies, I want to get out of my commodity plays then.
I think so. Oil bottomed around 33 bucks. It got up to 73, and just a couple of weeks ago it was 72, hanging just above 70 as the dollar was making its low. So I think that market's probably reversed, and so have most other commodities.
All right, we will leave it there. Great to have you on the program. We so appreciate your precious time today. Thank you.
Glad you're back.
We'll see you soon. Robert Prechter joining us, founder, CEO, Elliott Wave International. We've got about 30